What's up? So, really stoked on the workout today. Don't necessarily know where that pull came from. I pulled, that was 7:06. And what you may not understand or what you may not notice from the video, everybody that kind of understands how I pull realizes that I'm a very fast puller. I'm not a guy that's gonna be someone that grinds through a deadlift. I tend to utilize my speed, and wherever I slow down is kind of where I stop. So understanding this, I've looked at my deadlift in a lot of different ways. There was a guy that I was talking to in a forum not too long ago, and he was actually telling me that my form was shit. And you know, that's fine. Like, he was backing it up with some pretty valid points, so I wasn't mad. You know, so we actually discussed it a little bit, and he pointed out some things. And I've been looking at my deadlift, and a lot of people use the block pulls or rack pulls as ego lifts. And this is something that I've never ever understood. I think it goes back to something that Louis or Steve Goggins said, that they have to strain. Well, the guys that they were referring to, Steve, one referring to himself, who is one of the best deadlifters and powerlifters alive, and then Chuck, also, in my opinion, one of the best powerlifters alive. And I think anybody that says otherwise is foolish or a gear basher. But anyway, they mimicked their form on the rack pull. So if you were to juxtapose their pulling position from the floor to the point where they were at the rack, their forms were very, very similar. So many guys, when they do a rack pull or a pin pull or whatever it is, a block pull, will leverage themselves differently to maximize that positioning. And that's not what I'm trying to do. With me on this position right here, it's about 2.5 inches off the floor at weight. And in the beginning, it's about 3 with a, you know, with a plate to about 3 plates. And then as it gets on there, it bends down just a little bit. So for me, what I'm trying to really, really do, where I am a grip and rip type lifter, I've never had a problem with grip, so I'm trying something new. This may be at my own peril, but I'm using straps because my tendency is to grip and rip and actually use my upper body as a momentum force to help me drive with my legs. In this way, when I'm using the straps and I'm going over, it's really causing me to have to learn how to breathe, you know, in that position, which is gripped to the bar, stuck to the bar, and using my legs more, which I do feel like I get good leg drive anyway, but I'm really trying to slow the lift down. I'm trying not to, if you can understand the point I'm trying to make, I'm not trying to use momentum to get the floor or to get the weight moving up from the floor. I'm trying to use all my strength to get the weight moving. So, whereas I tell most people, if you're pulling 500 or 600 pounds and you can pull 700 pounds, to try to imagine putting 700 pounds into that bar, what I'm trying to do here, as you saw today, with 705 or 706, whatever it is, I'm trying to move the bar just fast enough to keep it moving, but not use any more momentum than I have to. So obviously, that was heavy for me. And even at my best ever, doing this movement this way prior to injury, I think I did 745 one time when I was deadlifting with Mark Miller. Now, when I've done well over 800, when I've used momentum and I was maybe using my leverages to my advantages or whatnot, but when I really slow the lift down and I try to find myself in the position that if you were to take a full from the floor lift and then a 2 to 3 inch block lift, they would be a mirror image of one another. So I'm trying to utilize the muscle groups the best I can from this position in the weakest way possible for me. And also another thing, this is a little bit atypical of what I would do. If you're trying to build a weakness, you want to do reps, you know, to get into the hypertrophy range. But I also know that my floor lift tends to be about 100 pounds behind what I can do right here. So if I can do 700 or so, which I did today, I'm not quite confident to say that I could pull 800 right now. But I do feel like in the very near future that'll be possible because I'm getting stronger in this range. And I'm actually learning to pull more slowly, if that makes sense. The accessory work that I've been doing a lot more of, I've been doing kettlebell swings, a lot of kettlebell swings. I know that one, they help me loosen up my hips a little bit, and they also kind of work the glutes. I'm really big into the snatch grip deadlifts and the kettlebell swings. When I do those as accessory work, I try to push my pelvis forward as much as possible, and I really try to squeeze the glutes as much as I can for like a 1-2 count. It's not like I'm trying to break the lift up and actually do like a pause, but when the kettlebell is extended in front of me and it's kind of in that point of weightlessness where it's at the top and it's getting ready to fall, I'm really flexing the glutes as hard as I possibly can for just a 1-2, and then I'm trying to slowly release the glutes on the way back down. Been doing a lot more, a lot more pull-ups than I have in the past. I'm not as good as I was before. Before my injury, I've gained some weight and I've just kind of gotten away from them a little bit. So I'm acclimating back to them. And what I'm basically doing is I'm doing sets of three and as many sets of three as I possibly can. And, I have a hesitation to use the band to get more because I'm just trying to force those reps. So tonight I got six sets of three, a pretty quick succession. 1-2-3, down for a few seconds. 1-2-3, down for a few seconds. So my next goal will be to do sets of five, and eventually a couple sets of 10 or a couple sets of eight, whatever it may be, but just keep the wheel moving forward. And those things really, really help me. I'm a big lat pull down guy. I do lat pull downs every single day. And that goes back to something. It's something that's been in my head for a long time. Louis talked about it. I talked to Kaz a lot about it. But the idea that you can force adaptation, you can force growth through minimal movements or, low intensity movements. And the best reference I can give you is thinking about the mechanic's hands. If you've ever turned wrenches for very long or turned a screwdriver at home, your hands tend to get really sore really quickly. They kind of fatigue out. Well, if you're a mechanic, that's your bread and butter, especially older mechanics. Guys have electric tools and air guns now, but older mechanics, had to do it all by hand. And I remember looking at my grandfather's hands and my great-grandfather's hands when I was a kid and just thinking like they looked like a catcher's mitt or something. They were so thick and dense and their fingers were so round. And that's something that kind of, you can see the thickness of my hand and so on. But over time, you just build a density. So, and it's never like you're turning a whole lot with that wrench. You just keep turning and turning and turning. Same thing for me. It's never like I'm using a maximum poundage on the lat pull downs. It's just 5 to 6 sets of 15 to 20 reps to really just put a lot of blood in there and try to expand the lats and really feel them. It's not something where I'm trying to jerk a bunch of weight. I'm really trying to feel and squeeze the lat as much as I possibly can. And I do that for my hamstrings as well. I was talking to a guy from the Warhouse gym. He's a deadlifter up there, or a lifter up there, and we were talking about his deadlift. Had some hamstring issues. 20-pound ankle weights, 100 to 200 reps a day. I know that sounds crazy, but just over time, the hamstrings will get a lot of blood in there. I think it'll do a lot of healing for you. It's something I've done for a long, long time. And I really felt a benefit from him. Louis Simmons was the one who told me to do that, not only for my hamstrings and my lats, but he also told me to do my core work that way. Just, do a lot of standing crunches and things like that. And Louis was notorious for coming in. And when we were on the night crew watching us train, he would just do set after set after set after set after set for his lats and for his core. And it was like, man, if this guy can do it, so can I, or I should at least be trying. And it's something I've always believed in. It's something I've held to. We're made to work as people, as human beings. We are designed to work. And I think sometimes we fool ourselves into thinking that we work really hard, but we condense our work into an hour or 2 hours a day. And, I think we can do a little bit more. So it's not like I'm sitting here blowing myself up with these lat pull downs and leg curls. It's just something I'll do like when I have some free time. It's 5 or 6 sets, but I do the leg curls consistently or straight through. Even if I get tired and my range of motion has to go down to a few inches for a few reps, I don't stop moving the weight. I just keep curling and curling and curling. So as you saw, back to the deadlift, that was 706. That is a big PR for me from that level. I don't think I've done that since I came back from my surgeries. And, you know, that's just good news for me. It's not like I'm going to be back trying to replicate or beat that PR next week or anything like that, but it's definitely a good sign that things are going in the right direction. My knee feels amazing. And for anybody out there that doesn't understand, I broke my toe yesterday, and you know, I could have been laid up on the couch, but there's guys that are competing that have no care whatsoever in the world that I'm hurt. They don't care. And that's the reality of it, is that guys are getting better and they don't give a shit if you're getting worse. All you gotta do is keep going, keep pushing forward, and keep believing in yourself. I certainly didn't prove anything to anyone today by pulling 700 pounds. I didn't scare anybody with that number, but for me, it proved a lot. And moving forward, the confidence that I gained for tonight, that might be something to scare a few people. Because I continue to get confidence, and the more I get back, the more I trust my body, the more that I can push. And you know, I think I am one of the better lifters in the world, or capable of being that. Not the best, but one of the better lifters in the world. If I can get my confidence back in my body and get it to do the things that I want it to do, I think I can beat my old self. And for me, that's a pretty good thing. So thank you guys for watching. I've got some more film to come. Like, subscribe, do all that stuff, share, whatever it is. Comment below. I'll try to comment back, answer as many questions as I can, but I really appreciate you guys for following. It's starting to pick up a little momentum, and that's really, really cool thing to see. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a great one. Silky Rob.
No, fucking
man. Look how fucking rad Silky Rob is.
Fucking man, are we live?
We're not live, but we're fucking alive. So, sitting here at Lynx, it's a pretty kick-ass place. Little bar, literally holds about 10 people. They make awesome burgers. They have great, great beer. So, I'm gonna check it out. Always know. To yourself, let go of perception, into true reality. Let go of perception, look and see from under the dark. So I got the bacon blue with spicy mushroom. It doesn't look like much for a burger cheaper than you can get at Wendy's. It's a fucking awesome.